Good evening and welcome to Tinkering with Etkelar. The Nabu PC modem project is coming along quite nicely, if a bit slow. It takes some time to program things in assembly, especially when the hardware has neither multiplication nor division. Sheesh! This episode is going to be a bit heavy on the software side of things, so if you're not into that, please leave the video on in the background so that YouTube counts the watch time at least. A few words about the design. I wanted a Wi-Fi connection to the internet and possibly a locally running version of a program repository, let's call it a local server, to provide the required data and storage capabilities to run programs on the Nabu. I used what I had experience with, an ESP8266 for the controller and Wi-Fi part, and a micro SD card for local storage. My first attempt also included an I2C EEPROM for settings, but either the breadboard or the controlling code was wonky. I couldn't get it to work properly. To solve the problem, I downsized slightly. The ESP does have a built-in EEPROM for hosting some files, so why not? After successfully testing the basic concept of the modem hardware with a breadboard version, I made a PCB design and got myself a prototype. To save on shipping, I ordered several PCBs for other projects too. I went with mostly surface mount for this one, but sheesh, 0603 parts. The metric kind, they are a bit on the too small for comfort side. One of the PCBs I ordered was the permanent version of the power supply adapter. Gotta update that one. And of course, also doing some fan service. The biggest issue is that the Nabu expects TTL level 5V signals, whereas the ESP and SD card need 3.3V logic. A level converter IC is needed. It has 8 channels and an enabled pin, which is a bit overkill for the two lines that I need, but it was also scheduled for the 5V EEPROM. Also, the enabled line is useful for programming the ESP. To use the serial programming mode, the TX and RX lines need to be free. As it is, I just enable the level converter after booting into regular mode. Also useful for diagnostics output instead of the HCCA connectivity. The programming of the ESP is done with an adapter. I didn't have any 3.3V serial chips, so I went with another level converted solution that plugs between my Arduino Mega and the modem board. The 6 programming pins provide power and pull the required pins for the programming mode. Plug in, hit program in the Arduino UI, and done. Thank you. The programmer interface also gets a PCB. Seems I got a few footprint issues in my first revision. Oh well, I never expected the initial one to be perfect. For a power supply, I choose to run with the now EU standard USB-C port. I put in the required resistors to indicate a power consuming device and a regulator to get both 5 and 3.3 volts on the board. As it is, I have 3 LEDs for signaling: Error, Network and I/O, to indicate any fault, Wi-Fi activity and SD or flash ROM activity respectively. I also use flashing signals, no need for a display really. And last but not least, there's a button on it too. Originally I went for a reset button, but just plugging the USB in again should be fine. This one is used to signal for a firmware update during boot and confirm choices. As of now, the serial programming is how the firmware gets onto the device. I am looking into the OTA update feature for later revisions to update from the SD card. Any in-depth configuration is supposed to be done with the Nabu PC already. To do this, the modem has a matching boot image in the EEPROM storage. This one can be updated during boot already, which makes it easy to replace it for testing. Put the image file into the root of the SD card, hold down the signal button during power on, and confirm with another click within 3 seconds. This will load the image into the EEPROM as a secondary image and then toggle the active image if the transfer was successful to prevent bricking. And now to the configuration program. It's coming together rather slowly, because I want to use it as a basis for whatever kernel function I want to offer at a later time. That means as clean programming as possible, so I can use some common I/O functions already. The program will feature several menu screens to configure the Wi-Fi settings, i.e. the SSID and key for connecting to the internet, the remote server settings, that is the server URL and login info, and local server settings, that is the configuration for the SD card. The idea for the local server is to have it override any network configuration. That means if you insert an SD card that contains the correct directories and files, the modem will boot into local server mode. That way, no reconfiguration is needed when changing from local to remote. Just reboot the modem. Overall, I'm still thinking positive about the project. Once the configuration and basis for the kernel is working, I can create a simple Hello World application and start coding the actual server. As of recording this video, I got the following items in the kernel up and running: a clear screen, clear end of line, set cursor location, and print subroutine for screen handling. The blinking cursor is still a work in progress. I also have the keyboard hooked up properly with an input buffer and function key handling, as well as a timer in the VDP interrupt. The send code is an untested copy of my earlier experiments, and the receive code is pending. Oh, and because I could, I also started a little user documentation for the modem, keeping the design closely to the original Nabu booklet. So, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this deep dive into the Nabu PC modem project. You can find any source code that is ready for public scrutiny on my GitHub account. I'll try to keep the Nabu PC episodes a bit more sparse, but the current state takes a lot of time away from other projects, so I got to put out what I have. See you next time! As it is, I just enabled the label. It's a level converter, not a label converter.